I was part of a lot of regional network, which was organizing a lot of exchange programs. And as someone who was participant of this program, and as someone who organized it basically in Montenegro and regionally, I can say that these programs are actually providing opportunity for young people to feel the change. Bringing them around some topics all together, to spend some time together, really after this time, after this kind of programs, those young people are changed. Then they are basing their own attitudes on their own experience and not on the experience of their fathers, grandfathers. After these exchange programs, after these opportunities, those young people are changed people, but they when they go back to their homes, to their schools, then they are transmitting this new energy. They are transmitting this knowledge. They are making new changes in their own communities, which is very important, and motivating other people to do the same. For me, the crucial thing is providing young people opportunities. We see that in the region there are lack of opportunities, generally for a mobility of young people. We see that there was in previous period a lot of opportunities to go abroad, to go out of the Western Balkan region. And youngsters usually would like to go to Germany, Italy, France, or whatever. But if you ask someone from Belgrade, do they want to go to Tirana, for example? They don't want simply to do that because they have a lot of prejudice, stereotypes, etc. But when they spend some time in Tirana, or young people from Tirana in Belgrade, they see that there are a lot of great places to spend some time. They get to know to the culture. They see that there are youngsters who share the same problems, but who share also the same values, dreams, opportunities, dreams, and that they want to see the Western Balkan region together, first of all, in peace and prosperity. And the standard of living is one of the key points. All of this actually were like arguments why to build some kind of regional structure. And at some point, all the people from civil society organization who were doing in this regard somehow understood also that the next step should be done. And next step for sure was to start to organize in some kind of regional structure, which would not be ad hoc, but which would be sustainable. And first of all, funded and established by the countries, governments from the Western Balkan region. That's for sure. As someone who was from the very beginning, I already said from 2014 as a civil society activist, I was also in 2015 elected to be a member of the working group for the establishment of RAIKO. I must say my personal and also professional beliefs that RAIKO shouldn't be just one grant-making organization. It should be a game changer in the region. It should be a thing which would provide people opportunity and really start thinking differently than we think before, and really to provide new energy for the region. 2016 was important not only because of the establishment of the RAIKO, but we see now for these 2 years it was a new energy for the region. It was a new energy to deal with the youth topics. It was a new positive impulse. I really do not see RAIKO as some organization which would be functional for a few years. I see it as a sustainable structure in the region which will grow. So the key point is to involve as much more young people from the region together through a project of exchange of young people. Basically, and one of the criteria is to bring young people together. They cannot do it virtually. They have to meet, they have to spend some time together. Having this experience from the exchange programs, having opportunity to make their own attitudes and judgments based on their own experience. When they spend some time together, they want to have a coffee together, they want to meet, they have friends in different countries, they are networking. In the future, it's possibility for new cooperation, for business cooperation. There is no alternative. This is the only way, actually. This is the only way. We must do it together. We cannot do it individually. Western Balkan region without cooperation simply does not have a future.